All right, so this seminar today we'll look at limits. What is a limit? So here's the definition of a limit. A limit is the y value a function gets close to as x gets close to a specified value. Limit is a y value a function gets close to as x gets close to a specified value. So limits are y values. They are actual y values that a function is approaching or getting close to as x is getting close to a certain value. So let's consider this equation that we have here. Here is a parabola. I have sketched the graph of it and I have put the equation over here. Y equals x squared minus x plus 1. So the question that we're investigating, let's move this up a little bit. Is let's find the limit as x gets close to 2. So let's find the limit as x gets close to 2. So that means, in other words, what is the y value on this graph approaching as x gets close to 2? Okay, so here is where x is 2. Okay, so as I approach 2 on x, so I'm getting closer and closer to 2, what does it look like the y value gets closer to? 3, right? It looks like the y values are getting closer and closer to 3. I could also say, okay, as I get closer and closer to 2 from this side here, as x gets closer and closer to 2, my y values are coming down to this point right here, which has a y value of 3. So we would say the limit as x gets close to 2 is 3. As x approaches 2, the y values are approaching 3. Now we could make up a little chart here. We could make up some x values and look at some y values. Okay. What I'm going to do is I'm going to start with an x value of 1. When I put 1 into this function, what's 1 squared? 1. Minus 1 is 0 plus 1. My y value is 1. Let's try a number that's closer to 2. Let's try 1.5. Well, that's going to be a bit tricky. Did someone do it? Thank you. 1.75. Someone want to try 1.9?
2.71.
And how about 1.99? So as we get our x values closer to 2, what does it look like our y values getting closer and closer to? It looks like, I mean, we could get kind of crazy here and try a bunch of nines, and we could probably see that this is going to go 2.99 or maybe 2.98. Is it 2.998? Oh, is that right? Yeah. So as you get closer and closer to 2, these values are approximately going to be 3. That's all a limit is. It's what our y value of our function is getting close to as x is approaching a certain value. So we can write limits this way. This is our notation for, we'll look at that example in a sec. We write them like this. The limit as x approaches 2 of our function, which was what? X squared minus x, what was it here now? Sorry. Plus 1. This is the notation for writing limits. The limit as x approaches 2 of our function is or equals 3. So let's consider this function, the limit as x approaches 0. Well, we cannot put 0 in here for x. Like for instance, here in this last one here, this one here, as x approaches 2, you can just put 2 in here. 2 squared is 4, 4 minus 2 is 2, 2 plus 1 is 3, and you can actually see that when you put 2 in the function, we're getting 3. So sometimes you can cheat a little bit. But this one you definitely can't. Remember the sine of 0 is 0. and divided by 0 you can't even do. Okay, so this one you can't substitute 0 in, but let's check it out. Let's do some x values and let's do some y values or some f of x values. Let's try some values. We're approaching 0. So let's try negative 0.5. How about negative 0.1? And then how about negative 0.01? And then let's try positive from the right, positive 0.5, positive 0.1, positive 0.01. Okay, so when we substitute in negative 0.5, what do we get? Sine of negative 0.5 divided by negative 0.5 is 0.95. 996, good. What if we tried negative 0.1?
0.998.
And what if we tried negative 0.01?
0.9999.
A lot of nines. So what does it look like the limit as x approaches 0 from the left is? What does it look like our y value is getting closer and closer to?
1.
Okay, so what if we tried from the right? So let's start somewhere to the right of the 0, say 0.5.
0.95.
Yeah, what you're going to see is that we're actually going to get the same answer here. Oops, that's a 0. So when we substitute these values in, it looks like the graph is getting closer and closer to the number 1. So even though you cannot substitute the value of 0 in, this function is undefined at 0. There is no y value at 0. We would still say the limit as x approaches 0 is 1. The graph is getting closer and closer to 1. Okay. Now let's look at a thing here. Nope, it's not going to open for me. Come on, open up. Thank you. Here we have a what? A nice line. Yes, we do. So we can play around with the slope of the line. We can play around with this here. Hold on a second. Here's what we want. Oh yeah, that's the view window dimensions. That's right. Okay. Okay, well now we're going to look at one-sided limits. And as the name suggests, it's looking at the limit from only one side, not both sides. So we can look at limits from one side or the other. We use a plus symbol if we are approaching the value from the right, and we use a minus symbol if we are approaching the value from the left. So here's an example. The limit as x approaches negative 3 plus of this function here, 2x minus 5. That means we're looking at the graph of 2x minus 5, but we're only seeing what the y value approaches when we approach negative 3 from the right. So we'd be looking at values like minus 1, minus 2, minus 2.5, minus 2.99. We're coming at it from the right-hand side. Here, this is a function. Here we are looking at the limit as x approaches 2 with a little minus. We're looking at the limit as we approach 2 from the left. Okay, so we can look at from the left or from the right. Often when we are looking at a function, the limit from the left will be the same as the limit from the right, like we saw in those examples so far. However, sometimes a function will have a different limit when approaching from the left side and the right side. So here's an example. What type of function do I have here? I have a piecewise function. I am saying the function is equal to this one here, 2x minus 3, as x is less than or equal to 2, and x squared plus 1 if x is greater than 2. So let's look at this example. Let's determine the limit as x approaches 2 from the left of this function. So if I'm approaching from the left, which one of these functions am I going to use? I'm looking at numbers that are smaller than 2 because I'm approaching from the left side. I would use the top one because I would use that function when x is less than or equal to 2. We don't have to have a graph, but let's put a little sketch of it on here. Let's do blue. Okay, this is just a very rough sketch. So this is the line 2x minus 3. It has a y-intercept of minus 3 and a slope of 2. So again, it's going to be really rough. It's going to look something like that. And then I have the parabola y equals x squared plus 1, which is going to look something like this. Okay. So what would be the limit as x approaches 2 from the left? I could just take 2.
Caitlin Overmeyer, see Mr. Nosey, please.
And I could substitute that in here for x. So I'm using this function as x approaches 2 from the left. 2 times 2 is 4. 4 minus 3 is 1. Here, now I'm looking at the function from the right, so I'm looking at this one. When I substitute 2 in here, what do we get? 2 squared 4, 4 plus 1, 5. So are the limits the same from the left and from the right? No. We have here a gap between those two points. So the function from the left comes up to 1. When we approach 2, here's 2 here. When we approach 2 from the left, the y value is going to get closer and closer to 1. When you approach 2 from the right, the y values are coming down to the number 5. Okay, so sometimes a function can have a different limit from the left side and from the right side.
Plus sign means come at it from the right.
Yes, plus sign means come at it from the right. Minus sign means come at it from the left. Okay, this is a really important definition. This is the definition of a limit. The limit of a function exists at a point, x equals a being some x value, if the following three conditions are true. Okay, very important definition of a limit. So we would say the limit exists if, first off, the limit as x approaches a from the left has to exist. In other words, we have to be able to come up with a number when we approach from the left. The second criteria is when we approach from the right, we must come up with a number. And the third criteria is when whatever we approach from the left and whatever we approach from the right must be equal or must be the same. So first off, the limit as x approaches a from the left exists. Secondly, the limit as x approaches a from the right exists. And thirdly, the limit as x approaches a from the left is equal, or the same number, as the limit as x approaches a from the right. So we have these three criteria. Let's look at some functions here and see if they hold true. Let's look at this one first of all. What is the limit as x approaches a from the left? Oh, sorry, we're looking at 2. So let's say this is our a. So we want the limit as x approaches 2. Can we approach it from the left? Yes, it exists. What does it equal?
1.
And no, the limit as x approaches 2 from the left, looks like my y value is getting closer to 1. Yeah? What is the limit as x approaches a from the right? So come at it from the right. What are the y values coming up to? 1. Are they equal?
Yes.
Yes. So does this limit exist?
Yes.
And it equals 2. Ah, 1. Yes, 1. The x value is 2. The y value, which is the limit, is 1. Okay, good. Another example. We're going to look at the limit as x approaches 1. So from the left, does it exist?
Yes.
Yes. What does it equal?
2.
2. The y values are steady here at 2. 2, 2, 2, 2, 2, 2, 2, 2, 2. What is the limit as x approaches 1 from the right? Does it exist?
Yeah.
Yes. Yes. Because as I approach one from the right, my Y values look like they're getting closer and closer to 3. Does the limit then, as X approaches 1, exist? No. Why not? Because they are not equal. The limit as X approaches 1 does not exist. Instead of the X, what we usually write is DNE. Mathematicians are lazy. Instead of does not exist, DNE does not exist. Every mathematician will know what DNE stands for. Okay, how about this one? We're going to look at the limit as X approaches 1. So let's start by looking at the limit as X approaches 1 from the left of this function.
No.
Can I approach 1 from the left? Does not exist. Well, as soon as one thing doesn't exist, the whole thing can't exist. So even though we can approach from the right, that's irrelevant. The function, the limit does not exist as X approaches 1. We can also look at infinite limits. So far we've been looking at the limit as X approaches 3, the limit as X approaches minus 2, the limit as X approaches 7. Okay? But there's infinite limits. So if the Y value of a function approaches infinity as X approaches A, then we find a vertical asymptote. So we now have a definition for vertical asymptote. So I've graphed here the graph f of x equals 1 over x. It's a reciprocal function. You've seen it before. So let's look at this one. Well, first of all, we're going to look at some limits as x approaches, finite numbers, and the limit approaches infinity. So what is the limit as x approaches 0 from the left of this function? So I'm approaching 0 from the left. So what's happening to my y values here as I get closer and closer to 0? They're going towards what?
Negative
infinity. What's happening to my y values as I approach 0 from the right?
Positive infinity.
If you approach a number, so as if you find the limit as x approaches a number 0, 2, minus 3, and the y values approach infinity, well, obviously then you've found a vertical asymptote because your y values are going towards plus or minus infinity. Well, just a sec. We'll talk about that. Here's another example, and this is the one I want to point out. Here's one I've got here. What is the limit as x approaches 0 from the left? What is the limit as x approaches 0 from the right? So, what can I say the limit as x approaches 0 of this function is? I can say it's infinity, because from the left and from the right gave me the same value. So we can say here, the limit as x approaches 0 of this function is positive infinity.
So you would not write, does not exist.
So let's look at horizontal asymptotes. So I've given you a picture here of a graph that has a horizontal asymptote at x equals 2. I know it kind of looks like 1 point something. Well, let's just say it's 2. What is the limit as x approaches infinity? What is the limit as x approaches infinity? So in other words, what's happening to my y values as I go to the right forever? What are the y values getting closer and closer to?
2.
Similarly, I can say, what is the limit as x approaches negative infinity? If I look at my y values as I move to the left forever, what is happening to my y values? They also are approaching 2. So, if you want to find a horizontal asymptote will exist if the limit as x approaches infinity ends up being a finite number. A lot of functions, like the good old parabola, doesn't have a horizontal asymptote. When you approach infinity from the right, it goes up to infinity. When you approach as x approaches negative infinity, it goes towards positive infinity. There's no horizontal asymptotes there.
These actually exist.
Yeah, limit as x approaches infinity is 2, we would say. We're not approaching left or right here. You can't approach infinity from the left or right. But we could say the limit as x approaches infinity of a function is, in this case, 2. Therefore, since 2 is a finite number, we have a horizontal asymptote at 2.